Hi everybody, it's me, Dr. Kestler from Lorain County Community College. Welcome to today's COVIDio. My temperature today is 96.1 Fahrenheit, for those of you who want to know. Today's a big day for number of cases. We are over a third of a million cases in the world. We have 15,000 deaths, and an important number to watch, which we haven't really talked about very much, is the number of people who are recovered. And the number of recoveries is important because those are people who can't be reinfected. Those are people who can be the helpers. Those are people who can go out and do things for us that we need them to do. So that's an important number to track as time goes on with this epidemic. So right now, I want to tell you, I posted something yesterday when I saw the numbers coming in, and I said storm. And we're about, the storm is here in the United States. We are in third place, and we have the fastest growing cases, the number of cases. We have the fastest growing number of cases right now, and we will soon overtake Italy in the number of cases, and then eventually I foresee us overtaking number of cases in China as well. I want to talk a little bit about more about social distancing, or physical distancing as I like to call it. Physical distancing is working and it's saving lives now. It's saving lives right now. This is not about the future. This is not hypothetical. It's real. So what you're doing, I know it is, everybody's getting on each other's nerves at the house, and I know it seems like a burden, but it is actually doing some good. And the reason is because if you look at the different countries, we have China, Italy, and the United States I have on this chart, and I'm looking at the number of deaths. United States is doing a lot better than both China and Italy. And the reason the United States is doing better than China and Italy is because, well, of the way we live, especially in our older years, the way we live. It is very uncommon in Italy to live in a nursing home. It is very uncommon to live in an assisted living care. It is very uncommon to live independently. And same goes for China. I have a student of mine who is from China, and she's telling me that the system in China is the older people go with the oldest child. They live with the oldest child. That is just how it's done. So unfortunately, the death rates that you see in China and in historically, the old, you know, back in early February and January were quite high because people were going home, and if one person in the family was infected, they all got infected, and that was a problem. So staying in place, staying away from people is a good thing. The fact of the matter is in this country, so China and Italy, elderly people tend to live with the family. In the United States, more people live independently or in assisted care or elder care or nursing homes. That is protective, and all we have to do is keep them and shelter them in. That protects them. It also, if we can protect them by staying away and not getting around, we can also not burden the healthcare system. Right now, in this area, we still have some, good healthcare available, but it could get really bad. So you know, you look at those deaths in the United States; they're still on the lower side, and that is a good thing. That is a real good thing here. As you guys know, yesterday, or it'll be enacted tonight, but yesterday, the health commissioner, Dr. Acton, announced that there would be a shelter-in-place order, which means that if you're out and about, not out running and not out exercising, that's a good thing to do, but if you're out doing something that you know, driving somewhere where you shouldn't be, then you can get a ticket for that. And this is something that is not just something that theoretically might work. It is working. Last slide I want to show you here is a slide of some data that some of my people worked up. Jennifer Marshall was helpful in this, and along with the entire Kestler Lab group, in working up some of this data. And this is the data, if you take everybody from their first day, the first case, the first death, and then follow the outcome, you can see from this chart that, first of all, China is basically had a lot of cases, and they're basically done. There's actually a little good news in this slide, and I think you're seeing the tapering off of deaths in Italy. I've also noticed a trend of new cases being down in Italy as well. So to all my Italian friends, Viviana, Giuditta, in bocca al lupo to you. May you survive in the mouth of the wolf. And so you can see some of these trends, and I think we're going to see much better course because of social distancing, because of physical distancing protocols. I think you're going to see some good numbers in America. So you're all doing good work. So keep it up. Your staying at home and not getting out is not for is for a reason, and it is helping. I'll leave you with the you be the helper. My last slide here is the you be the helper. You are the helper. Staying home, not doing something, is sometimes the best thing. And that's where I'll leave you today. Thank you all for tuning in to the MicroProf Learning Network. Remember, be good to each other, and may you persist like a lentivirus. Thank you.